Hey everyone, so I'm here in my backyard. I don't know if you can see this, but there's actually like a great blue heron just chilling back there. But today we're gonna do a video. Why? Because I want to. Why? Because it's what I do. So today's topic, clickbait spirituality. What is clickbait spirituality? Well, I'll tell you, it's pretty much when you got this surface level and it seems like it has substance because they phrase it to have substance, but it's just nothing. In reality, it's people who are trying to perceive something or try to tell you something it is, but it's just literally, it's kind of like when you eat, well, there's not much of an analogy for this because no matter what you consume, there's substance. In this case, there's no substance. There is literally just a surface level, a gleam, something that makes it look nice, but in reality, it's just like not even legitimate. Because there's no answers that you're going to find external to. You might find inspiration. You might find things that are worded properly. You might find ways that are better suited for you to understand any spiritual essences or practices or even that is associated with like occultic wisdom. But none of these are ever going to tap you into the one thing that matters. And the one thing that is actually proven to say that, hey, spirituality is going to come from to who you are as an individual. It is your perception of that reality, your perceptions and your belief system and what you perceive to be this outside world, this bigger picture at play. What kind of faith do you have to say that is existing within and around you? Now, if you're searching for answers or if you're looking for the answers, now I'll tell you right now, there's a lot of deception out there. There's a lot of mixed bags out there and there's a lot of things that are willing going to try to catch you in because they harness your energy. They harness what it is that you want to believe in. Some individuals, you can even go as far as the idea of concepts of entities in themselves can harness these energies and they might not have a form, but if you're willing to provide them the belief system, the faith, then that right there is something in which you're giving your thought process, even on a minuscule wavelength in which you are processing this thought out there and intended to provide this, whatever it is that you perceive, as the main course. So what should people do about this? Now, the number one question that I have to put out there is it important to you? And does it change what you're doing on your path? Because many of us are looking for answers. We're looking to find what it is that actually means something to us. Why do we want these answers? That's because there's something deeply rooted that we are searching for, something that is beyond who we are as individuals. Something that goes deeper, maybe at the soul level. Maybe that incorporates something that is more of spirit, or the way in which, why are we here? Where did we come from? And what kind of questions are we asking to go beyond that? So when we're searching for things like that, we are given all sorts of information, and now all of it is a leap of faith. Now, when you've got something that you cannot prove, you're in a state in which you are never, ever, ever going to change that. For example, the concept of a multiverse, the concept of off-planet entities, the concept of any of the things in terms of existing outside besides what individuals perceive, interpret, and then project or process or put out there. That is literally the surface level in which you're receiving that information. So you're already at a state in which this information that is trying to be told to you as something of substance is already coming from an individual's perception. So you can only take it for the face value and weight in which that is. Now, it doesn't matter. Anyone can believe whatever they want, but that's an illusion. Now, the ability is that if you want to understand the nature of universe, understand nature in its own right, there's not a single thing that occurs all around us that is not replicated or seen at an as above, so below level within the natural world. And that's a beautiful thing, because whether you're looking at the cosmos or looking at the micro, there's this essence of things that are going on. Now, you look at those common links, the common things that hold those, that allows such analogy to take place, you're definitely starting to get right on tune to things. But that is for you to decide on what it means. That is for you to come to your conclusions. You can read some great books, you can listen to some great individuals, and you might be given some insight. But at the same day in which you're receiving this, you are making the choice. Are you just allowing this information to become a part of you and take it as for a fact? Or are you just allowing this to be an experience in which you're hearing a perspective so that you may take in and better understand what it is that you want to perceive out there in the reality? Now, I'll tell you what you can and can't control. You can control yourself and how you view the world, but you cannot control anyone else around that. There will be people who are going on paths that you might not even want to go down. It's not your job to do something about that. But at the same time too, if they don't want to listen, they don't want to listen. If people are so committed to what they're doing, then these individuals are under the substance of something that's more akin to like fandism, in which they believe their system so much that their paradigm is shaped around it, that if you try to challenge it, then that already is just going to set up some like red alerts for these individuals to pretty much like defend whatever it is that they feel is meaningful, or whatever paradigm that they are in is being challenged, they have to back it up. Now, the thing is, an individual who is so open and open-minded to understand, to best really find the truth of what really is, then you're not gonna pretty much say, oh, I found gold, in reality, it's just rocks. You want to shake all the rocks out so that what you have is the real substance. So what you have is something that matters. So when you're dealing with this clickbait spirituality, it's all surface level. It's never going to take you there. If you're going to look for an answer, if you're going to look for something, you got to go within. If you're upset about what you're going through, you might seek universe or divination or all various forms in which you can be provided insight through synchronicity and messages so that you can integrate into the awareness, provide yourself the opportunity to move forward with your life and to recognize your path. But no matter how you look at it, if you're looking externally for answers, you're totally missing the ballpark, because everything that you need is within. Your whole dreamscape, the whole fact that you can actually receive inspiration, ideas, concepts, and even feel so gut right about certain aspects of what you should be doing with your life. And then on top of that, your own unique nature. So all these things are worth understanding. And if you want to go deep somewhere, go deep within who you are as an individual. Because I'll tell you straight up, you can follow whoever you want, you can take whatever courses, and you can join whatever schools you wish. But unless you're willing to go by yourself and allow yourself the opportunity, then you are going to provide these other individuals the power, because you want to trust. But at the same time too, if you're on a journey of trusting yourself, no matter where you are, you will not be lost. And that's a beautiful thing. So if you want to definitely try to advance your spiritual practice, understand the difference between religion and spirituality. Religion is going to be a following. Spirituality is something that you decide for yourself. It's not going to be the same for everyone, and it's all going to be your own unique perspective. An individual who might have an encounter or an experience might have a different view from somebody who's so closed off from the world. But that doesn't change. An experience speaks for us. Think about your dreams. Think about the things that are beyond us. We're not just this physical. We want to know what's beyond. But sometimes, do we need to know? If you know your path, then I think that's clear. And if you're meant to experience something, then you right will certainly have that come to your way. So before I get you too long here, let's just say, if it's clickbait spirituality, you know, because there ain't no depth. So until next time, guys, stay true.